And start standing up.
All right, welcome to yoga. We are here again, together again on our mats. Trying to heat up this little room here. We're going to start standing. I'm just going to gently pound out the hips a little. Give your pelvis a little stimulation. Get around the back. Maybe do a gentle pound on the lower back. Just kind of waking it up. We've been sitting and walking and driving and mute. Sugar, did you mute yourself? All right. Go ahead and make sure you're muted. And also, before I forget, don't forget to put your name in the chat. Last week, we missed a few people. Okay. So let's actually take the left leg and take it behind the right leg. And then take both arms up above the head. And if you can kind of see me, I don't know if you can see, I'm grabbing my wrist with my right hand, the wrist of my left hand, and my left foot is behind me. And I'm just gently pulling the wrist of my left hand, pressing the pelvis slightly forward, and just getting that stretch all the way along the side of the body, down through the hip. And what I do here to kind of torque, a little left, and then a little forward, a little backwards and forwards, I guess. So kind of pulling the pelvis to the left, and then to the right as much as it can go. And yeah, good, release. And then try the other side. Woo, that's intense. right leg behind the left. Both arms up in the air, grab hold of your wrist with your left hand, and then gently pull that wrist to the left, pressing the hips forward slightly. And then when you're ready, just kind of torque, gently swinging forward and back. Yeah. So I kind of want to do a full body reset today. That's kind of my goal. I don't know exactly what that means, but I think in my mind, it means that we might do less and let the less be more. So I hope you guys will approve of that. The Less is More Body Reset by Ariane. Let's take a nice deep breath in. And we're just actually going to keep our arms in parallel. So not grabbing the arms or interlacing the fingers, rooting the feet into the ground, dropping the scapulas down the back, lengthening the arms by the ears and reaching the fingertips towards the ceiling. As soon as you do this, you should kind of feel an activation of your whole body. And the energy is shooting up from those rooted feet, spread wide on the floor. And then energy just kind of beaming up from the ground through the ankle, through the calf, through the knee. Feel that knee joint just kind of light up. And then the quads light up and the pelvis lights up. The abs engage, the rib cage kind of floats, the shoulders are dropped, the arms are reaching. This is your full length, full strength in your length. And just kind of feel that, feel that, feel that, feel that. And then let's bend the knees over the toes and push that rock in front of us, curving the back slightly, tilting the pelvis forward, and push against the camera as if you're trying to push a big rock. Pull that lower back towards the wall behind you and really move that belly button towards the wall. Good. And come up. Let's interlace the fingers behind the back in the way that you usually don't interlace the fingers. So it kind of feels a little weird. Take the hands to the right hip and look over your right shoulder. Drop those elbows and send them behind you, back and down. And switch. And now we're going to do a series of gentle arm movements to connect our body with our breath. So let's take those arms up into goalposts. We're going to inhale, sending those elbows just slightly back behind the rib cage, but don't stick the butt out and don't release the rib cage. So just take those elbows slightly back on the inhale. Exhale, kiss those elbows together. Let's just keep going here for a bit. Keep those elbows lifted, almost like you're pulling them away from you as you exhale. Good. Take the hands to the elbows. We're going to scoop the elbow down and around, involving the rib cage. So we're actually letting the rib cage tilt with the elbow, and we're drawing kind of a circle with each side forward with the right and then forward with the left. Keep those elbows back. And then you can even push your hips out a little bit side to side as you do this, just to kind of get a little bit of loosening up. And then try the other way, forward with the elbow, forward with the elbow. Try to continue with your breath. Good. Taking that left arm, the left arm is bent and then the right arm is straight. We're gonna sweep across the front and then sweep across the front with the other. Inhale, pull that elbow back. Exhale, try the other side. Like you're spreading, like maybe like lightly putting your fingers on top of the water as you kind of sweep across the front. Pull that elbow back and sweep that arm across. So you're really getting that spot right underneath the scapula to stretch as you reach across the body. And then try that with a forward motion. Elbow, 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 elbow. You can even take it into a full arm. Keep that breath going. And then the other way. Good, and take them out and press the sides of the room with your palm, root your feet, tight glutes, hold, breathe, engage those, the core. Take that elbow up and reach the fingertips towards each other behind you. Maybe you can grab hold of them. Maybe they're just aiming for each other. Send the elbows back. Breathe. And undo them and redo the other side. And release, and let's just do a few head circles very slowly. Right ear to right shoulder, chin to ceiling, left ear to left shoulder, chin to chest. One more time. Other direction. I like to do box breathing with this. So I inhale as I bring my ear to my shoulder, exhale, up, inhale, other side, exhale, down. Good. Let's take a nice deep breath in. And we're gonna exhale and dive all the way down. First, we can hang out here, just hands on our knees. Maybe bend the knees over the toes, push out of the knees so you're not falling into your shoulders. I'm wagging my tail here. And then we're gonna exhale, contract the pelvis, look down, standing cat-cow. And inhale, arch, look up. Good. Woo. Go ahead and gently lengthen the legs out as you let the torso fall forward. First forward fold. So we need to go slow. Shake it out. Grab some blocks if you need them or want them, or just to kind of give yourself a little support. Maybe bounce the knees a little. Maybe create a few figure eights with your pelvis. And then try the other direction, which is always a little counterintuitive. Shake out the head no, and shake out the head yes. And maybe a big sigh here. Oh, yeah, gotta sigh it out. All right, we're gonna hang out here for a bit. So I want you to, you know, play with where your weight is on your feet. Find the equal distribution of weight between the two feet, not too much on your heels and not too much on your balls of your feet, neither right nor left, but really centered. Lift the belly button towards the spine. Oh yeah, already that's gonna give you an added stretch in the hamstrings. Isn't that crazy? Now you can stay here. You can always, if you need to, come to a bended knee and put your elbows on your knee if you need a little rest. You can also take the elbows in the hands. We're just going to breathe here like 5 deep breaths. On that last exhale, take the hands to the mat and slowly bend the knees over the toes, lifting the heels off the floor. Walk the hands forward into plank and hold plank. Press the hands out into the floor and lift your body away from your shoulders. Breathe here. So less is more today. So we're just gonna really work our plank. We don't need to do anything fancy. We don't need to lift the leg. We don't need to bring the knee to the nose, the knee to the elbow. Beautiful, solid plank today. We're gonna walk the hands back to the feet, slowly bending the knees back into our nice little curl, dropping the head to the floor. And then slowly rolling back up to standing. Last thing to come up is the head. Take your time. We're gonna do a roll down and go right back into plank. So when you get there, reestablish your mountain. Big breath, and on the exhale, start your way down again. Nice and slow, vertebrae by vertebrae. We're articulating each vertebrae. And then when we get to that forward fold, we release that head and the heels come off the floor. And we come into that curve of the spine. And then we walk the hands out into plank. And we're gonna hold plank again. feel the beautiful suspension between the top of the head and your heels. The top of your head is reaching forward. Your two heels are reaching back, and everything else is like a plank. Breathe. And bend those knees, walk the hands back, all the way back into that curve one more time. Send the heels to the floor, back into your forward fold. And one more time, slight bend in the knees, roll back up to mountain. And we're actually gonna go into tree right here. So just find a tree, simple, easy tree. Reestablish your vertical. Breathe. When you're ready, open up those arms from tree and grab the outside of the knee, keeping your knee close to your chest, but to the side. Circle that ankle. And then take the knee forward and switch arms. Open up the torso to the right and just pull that right elbow back behind you. So you're having a gentle spinal twist, but you have that balancing challenge. This is gonna generate heat, yeah? So we're doing our warm up, but it's just slow. And we don't have to work too frenetically to get that heat going. Try the other side when you're ready. Settle your breath. Take those arms, open them wide as you lift the knee to the hand. Circle that ankle when you're ready. And then bring it front. Switch hands. And this is a tricky part, changing your focus. Opening up that torso to the back. Take the elbow back. If you want, you can open up the arm too. But even just pulling that elbow back and dropping the scapula, changing the focus, and then bring yourself back around and release. I'll meet you guys back down in plank. So find your own way to get there. You can do a roll down, or you can do the beginning of a sun salutation, like a swan dive, whatever you want, back into plank. We're going to hold here 5 breaths. On the 5th exhale, booties to the ceiling, yogis. Let's find our down dog. Ooh, feels so good. Do what you need to do in down dog. Tread the feet, lift the heels. Maybe lift one leg, circle it around, loosen up that hip joint. We're just gonna do 3 transitions from down dog to plank. Here we go. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. Beautiful. All right, let's just Lift that right leg up in the air and bring it forward to the outside of our right hand. Yeah, this kind of, I think it's actually lizard. I always call it runner's pose. Go ahead and drop the knee and untuck the toe. We're gonna take our hand to the back of our head. On the inhale, we're gonna open up the body and take the elbow to the ceiling. On the exhale, we're gonna trace a rainbow up and forward and across to our other elbow, our left elbow, and then back again. Inhale, open up. See if you can see the ceiling. Trace that elbow forward and across. Let's do that three more times. Beautiful. Go ahead and see if you can take that left hand off the floor. You can have your hands behind your back, or you can put them in prayer and send the fingertips down the back. Lift the chest to the ceiling slightly and send the elbows back. And hands come back down to the mat. Tuck that toe and send the right leg back to down dog. Maybe do a few treading of the feet here. Maybe you want to do one plank and back to down dog. Lift the left leg and step it through to the outside of your mat on the outside of your left hand. Go ahead and drop the knee and untuck the toe. Go ahead and take the left hand up behind the head, and let's open up that elbow to the ceiling and look up and behind us. Now we're gonna trace that rainbow forward, down, across and under. And then inhale back around. Three more times for a total of five. Really focus on the breath. Woo, that feels good. All right. Bringing the torso up. You can have the hands behind the head still, or you can take them into prayer, send the fingertips back, lift the chest, elbows go back. Feel that nice long stretch in front of the hip flexor, the hips. Woo. Oh yeah, I can take my elbows back. Further, can you? And then bring those hands to the mat, tuck that back toe, and come back to down dog. Let's come on to our hands and knees for a second, or actually maybe even onto our knees. I think we've got some new people. Hi, welcome. Let's just take the hands out and circle those wrists a bit. Good. All right, coming on to all fours. We're actually gonna come into puppy. I don't know if it's really puppy. We're gonna walk those hands forward and we're gonna keep the pelvis above the knees. And then we're going to let the chest fall and rest the forehead on the floor. So the pelvis stays above the knees. It's kind of like a baby down dog, but this time we're actually letting the chest kind of arch. Ooh. I think it is puppy, but I don't know. I like the idea of it being puppy. And then come up and bring those hands back underneath the shoulders. And let's take the right ear to the right hip, making the letter C for Sherry, who's here today with us. And then a backwards C for Sherry's alter ego. And let's try it again, other side. And other side. All right, good. Tuck those toes. We're gonna come back into down dog. We're gonna do a very gentle flow here. All right, all we're gonna do is move between down dog and that lizard pose. So we're gonna inhale, lift that right leg out, send it to the outside of the right hand, and then bring it back to down dog. Inhale, left leg, exhale, bring it forward on the outside of the left hand, and then send it back. So we're really alternating from lizard on the right into down dog into lizard on the left. Let's do three sets, right, left. I'm actually stepping off my mat because I need to get it. I don't want to be half on, half off. So I'm just stepping on the floor, right on the outside edge of my mat. That also helps me get the foot forward. Good, all right. And come on down. You've got blocks, grab them, put them behind you. Go ahead and take your hands behind you onto your blocks or grabbing hold of your ankles. Or if you want, just take your hands, place them on a lower back, fingertips facing down, elbows back. Inhale, and on the exhale, lift the chest to the ceiling, let the head come back, tight glutes, arch. And release. Good. All right, that marks the end of our warm-up. Grab some water. We're going to do our pranayama. And today, I invite you to, since we did some cool arm movements for our warm-up, to do your pranayama with whatever arm gesture feels good to you. So you don't have to do the reach in the prayer. You can do a swish like we were doing before with a rainbow. Just do something, arm and a cross and an open arm and a cross. So whatever arm gesture, it's yogi's choice. All right, whenever you're ready. Pranayama. Last three. And let's take one nice scoop down, out, up. Interlace those fingers, send the palms of ceiling to the ceiling. Drop the chin to the chest. Walk the shoulders up the ladder. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Ah, keep that length as you bring those arms down slowly. All right. Full body reset in the house. Let's take the right leg forward into that like runner stretch. This time, instead of focusing on the torso, going close to the leg, let's just kind of rotate the leg in the hip joint. So turning the leg out with the toes pointing out, and then rotating the joint and to print, bringing the toes in. So the hands stay on the mat. You try to keep your pelvis nice and straight and still while you gently rotate the leg in the joint, right and left. You feel how that affects the stretch. Ooh. Lots of little subtle things we can do with a lot of the vocabulary that we've been using for years and years and years and just kind of tweak it. And honestly, sometimes just playing around is when I discover that these things work in a funny way. All right, take that leg back and switch. Bring the left leg forward. Sometimes I just pick up the leg and put it in front of me because it's a little awkward. Hands on either side. And now I'm just trying to keep the pelvis still. And I'm just rotating that femur in the hip joint, which then affects their whole leg. And my toes should be literally rotating towards the top of corner of my mat and then the other top corner. Your fingers and your spine. Take the right toe, your hands, and bring that leg back around. Put the right leg, and let's just do this bones kind of reaching down towards the ground for your heel. And then coming up and then slightly forward so you can get a little wrist stretch and then back. So you can actually bring your shoulders like 5 inches in front of your hands just to get that core activated. You can tell how it kind of activates your core and you get that little wrist stretch. And if you want, you can even flip the hands, like one hand over and then come back. And then flip the other hand over. Ooh, that's interesting. Never did that before. Or even bring the wrists forward and fingertips back and then switch them around as you send the pelvis back. So as you come up, you kind of rotate the wrists. Oh, that's interesting too, see? All right, let's come up with our hands underneath our shoulders. Let's take that right arm up and out. Wait a minute. Yeah. Let's weave the arm underneath and send the cheek to the floor. Our right leg is still out to the side. Now you can leave the hand on the floor, the right hand, or you can lift it and look up to your left. And then come on up and let's switch hands. So left arm comes up, weaves underneath the right, left cheek goes to the floor, pelvis goes back, and then lift the right arm up. Oh, wow, that feels good.
in the upper back ribcage area. And then come on up and let's switch sides. Okay, just taking a little moment here, sweating. Let's try the other side. Set yourself up, left toes facing forward. Hands slightly in front of the shoulders. Regular old rock and roll. Back and forth, dropping the pelvis down to the heel, and then coming forward just a few inches past the shoulders, keeping that heel on the floor. And then just play with your wrists if you want to, with different directions of your fingertips and different facing of the palm, up or down. Yogi's choice. All right, bringing those hands back underneath the shoulders. This time we will lift the left arm up. Bring it, weave it through underneath the right, left cheek to the floor. Push into the floor, set the pelvis back, and open up that right arm if you want. And then bring it down, push into the floor, come back up, switch sides. Right arm comes out, weaves through, right cheek to the floor, pelvis drops a little bit further back, open up the left arm. And come on up. All right, let's have a seat on our booty. And bring the soles of the feet together. I'm steaming up the joint here. All right, soles of the feet together. Grab hold of those feet. Open them like a book, literally. Open those feet up. Use your elbows to press into the calves or the knees gently. And just breathe here. Good. We're going to take a nice deep breath in, scooping the energy up and forward over those feet, hands in front of the toes, and just let the head be heavy. Drop the knees. If this hurts, you can always put your blocks underneath your knees just to give you a little support. Just really want you to release the torso, release the spine, the upper part of the back, the neck, the chin, and the chest. Walk the head over to the left. Take the hands forward on the diagonal. Reach the right hand kind of right in front of the left shin. Root the right hip down. Drop the shoulders down. Ground the pelvis down, lift the belly. Walk the hands forward to the other side. Fingertips shooting forward off the right shin, rooting the left hip, heavy head. Big breath. And forward, being really careful to come up. Walk the hands slowly so you can bring your torso up. Take the knees in the hands and lift them up because that was a big stretch. Send the legs forward. And let's just pull the flesh from out from the ground, and so we can sit nice and tall on our six bones. Big breath in. Good. Let's bring the left knee up to the chest. Scoop that right arm around the knee and just open up the chest. Keep this the right foot flexed. Looking over. Now we did this standing, yeah? So see if you can get that same length that we did when we were standing in your torso. Is your belly lifted? And now go ahead and open up that arm. Good. And let's come back. Extend that leg. Nice deep breath in. Arms come up. As we exhale, we bring the knee to the chest. We hook that elbow in and we twist. Coming in from up above. Lengthening, finding that long line from the six bones to the top of the head. And come on back. Let's cross the right knee over the left and see if you can to get the knees on top of each other. Again, I sometimes have to actually pick them up and move them because they don't go on their own. Okay, for me, this is a good enough stretch. We're getting that deep right glute, right hip, if your right leg is on top. Now, you can stay here and just breathe. If you want a little bit more of a stretch, inhale, taking the arms just down on the diagonal. On the exhale, sweep the arms forward and drop the head or even the eye socket into that top knee. One of the eye sockets, or both eyes, I guess you can't really have both. You need two knees for two eye sockets. Breathe here. And walking the hands up. Lean back a little bit, unhook those legs, send them out into a nice V shape, not too wide. Give yourself a little bit of a rub down. We're going to do the other side in a second. We're going to do a few abs right here, pancake abs. Flex the feet so the heels come off the ground. Inhale, tilt forward, keeping the toes up to the ceiling. Exhale, come up. You don't want to let the legs roll forward. You want to maintain that turnout with the heels reaching up towards the ceiling. Exhale up. This is gentle. We don't need to do, it's not like a hardcore thing, but it's also really good for our back. You can feel your back working, but you also want to feel your abs pushing the back back up like the silver platter, lifting the spine. Two more. And come up. Good. Let's just take the right arm over to the side and just give a gentle little dancer stretch here. And the other side. Mm-hmm. All right, let's recross. This time left over right. Try and stack those knees. That's the hard part. You also want your six bones on the floor. Yeah. So, okay, yeah, I feel that. Let's just sit here for a minute and lengthen the spine. Lengthen the hands down by the side, kind of like on the diagonal. You can stay here and breathe, or you can sweep the hands forward And then just rest. Eye socket to knee and breathe. And walking the hands up and tilting back, uncrossing those legs, sending them out one more time, V shape. Actually, let's bring the right foot into the left thigh, and then we'll take the big toe in our fingers and then just sweep that arm up and over. Opening up the chest to the ceiling, just a few seconds here. And come up, switch sides, other side. All right, good. Let's come on to our back. We're gonna do our bridge work here. Feet flat on the floor about, I don't know, half a foot away from the pelvis, hands down by our sides. Inhale. We're going to scoop the belly button, and that's going to automatically tilt the pelvis, which is then going to lift us into our bridge. We're going to stay in bridge. We're going to breathe here. Less is more today. Every time you exhale, I want you to send energy from your feet down into the floor. And countering that, you're sending energy from the glutes up towards the ceiling. Starting to feel a little hard. I want you to push through that. Just breathe into it. Three more breaths. On the next exhale, slowly bring that pelvis down to the ground and lift the knees to the chest. Good. Just hug the knees to the chest. We're going to do a very slow meditative flow. We've done it before. We lift the arms as we lift the pelvis into bridge. So we sweep the arms up overhead, the top of the hand taps the floor above our head, and then we begin to come down, matching the arm and the pelvis movement. That's the tough part, right? You gotta manage that parallel movement, and your arms are going a lot further than your pelvis. So your arms have to move a little faster. Keep those knees right over your ankles. Don't let the knees kind of widen or go out. Try to keep those two parallel lines. And let's just focus on the breath. Matching the inhale with the rise of the arms and the pelvis, and matching the exhale with the lowering. Three more. Wow, good job. Glutes are on fire. Rock it out, knees to chest. Circle them around to the right. And circle them around to the left. Go ahead and take the hands out to your sides, palms down. Let the knees fall to the right. Look over your left shoulder. Just breathe a couple breaths here. And then send the feet down towards the bottom of your mat, just about a foot. And then take the left arm and reach it up on the diagonal. I'm having a problem with that because something's in my way. But now you have that long diagonal stretch from your fingertips down through the rib cage into the lower left back and the lower glute. The lower glute, the glute. I don't think there's two glutes, lower and upper. Although in my case, sometimes, yeah, there are. All right, back up. Let the knees fall to the left. Look over the right, palms down, few breaths just right here. Send the feet down towards the bottom of your mat, just about a foot. Take the right arm up on the diagonal. If your feet are too close to your glutes, you're not going to get the stretch. You want them. You want your legs kind of at a right angle. And back up. All right, we're gonna do some simple core exercises. We've already done some core just with our plank. We did this last time, I think. So we're gonna extend the body on the mat, arms above the head. We're going to come all the way up to boat. And then we're going to bring the hands to prayer and twist down right, left, right, left, extend. Eight sets, just eight. Inhale, exhale, reach up to boat, hold. Inhale, arms come to prayer. Exhale, right, left, and extend. Inhale, exhale, boat. You can always take your feet to the floor if you want to on these twists. Right, left, extend, and up. That's four. One more. I like those because they really get every single part of your rectus abdominis, the lower ones, the side ones, the middle ones, the top. And now we're done. Eight abs and we did it all. Shake it out. Whew. Let's take that right leg over the left. Right ankle over left knee. Thread the needle.
pull that thigh towards you as you send the knee away. And switch. And release and go ahead and grab those toes. We'll come into happy baby. Just a little rocking, easy right and left, keeping that lower back on the floor, flat on the floor. And take those legs up in the air, give them a little shake out. Then we're going to lower the legs to the floor for a count of 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, stretch the arms away from the toes. Hold the breath, squeeze every part of your body. Hold, squeeze, get all of that tension. Build it up, build it up, build it up. And release. Stick out your tongue, swallow. Stick out your tongue. Ah. Ooh, that was a good one. Go ahead and find yourself, get yourself into a deep relaxation, corpse pose, hands down by your sides. I'm going to turn down my lights a little bit. We're going to do a brief relaxation, allowing the work that we've done to kind of course through our body. Close your eyes. Just relax.
And bring yourself back to the room or stay in Shavasana, bringing your hands to prayer, finding a comfortable seated position, and we'll close our class. With gratitude for the opportunity for new, fun discoveries, different approaches. Sometimes they feel weird. And gratitude for that. Gratitude for weird feelings. The spirit in me salutes the spirit in you. Namaste. If you haven't already, put your name in the chat so that we know how many people came. And I hope to see you again next week.